and welcome to Martlet Volleyball Tonight on SSN Canada. I'm Riley Wayman, and I'm here with my broadcast partner, Chris Wilhelm, at McGill's Love Competition Hall, getting ready for the start of the McGill Martlets home opener against their QSSF rival, the Laval Fougeol.
That's right, Riley. The Martlets are 3-1 in their last four games, which makes them 3-3 on the season. And they are looking to pick up a win tonight in a tough match against the undefeated Rouge d'Or
volleyball squad. We have a few keys to the game for the McGill Martlets volleyball team. The McGill Martlets have to hit hard against the Laval squad. They're averaging only 11.4 kills per game compared to an opponent average of 11.6. In order to pull out the win, the Martlets are going to need to out-hit their opponents in tonight's match. Another key for the Martlets will be to put up their block. McGill is entering the game averaging only 2.0 blocks per game compared to an opponent average of 2.6. For the Martlets to be successful against the hard-hitting Rougeol squad, they're going to have to put up some strong blocks tonight. Wouldn't you agree, Chris?
Oh, absolutely. The block is a big part of McGill's game, and they're going to need to get it going if they want to beat Laval here tonight. For Laval, our first key is going to be keeping their service errors down. Coming into the game tonight, the Rougeol have made 54 service errors, which is a lot compared to McGill's 30. And key number two for Laval is going to be to keep things simple. We talked with head coach Alain Pelletier before the match, and all he had to say was that he wanted his squad to play smart the entire match, which has been working for them thus far in the season.
Yes, he was saying that he wanted to play a very straightforward game and keep the simple parts of their game under control. That means he doesn't want to see any service receive errors or any attacking or blocking errors or anything like that.
Of course.
We also talked to Rachel Beliveau, the head coach of the Martlets in her 20th season with the squad, and she was saying that she is looking forward to a great game tonight. Going into the game, the Laval squad is ranked first overall in Canada, and she said it's going to be a tough game, but McGill has won previous home openers against the Laval squad, so they're looking to repeat that tonight.
Yeah, they're definitely looking to keep that tradition alive. It's going to be tough. Laval, as we have said, is undefeated thus far in league play.
Your officials for tonight's match are the first official is Martin Kingsbury, and your secondary official is Alain Simard. Right now you can see the hard-hitting Laval team warming up their spikes. And right beside us, we have the McGill Fight Band setting up, so you will hear them repeatedly throughout the match. Now a word from our sponsors. Our second half sponsor is Ye Olde Orchard Pub and Grill. Head on over to the after the game for some post-game refreshments with three locations to serve you across Montreal. One at 5563 Monkland, one at 1189 Rue de la Montagne, and one at 20 Prince Arthur West. It is the official after party of this game. Our halftime sponsor is Domino's Pizza, the official pizza of McGill Athletics, and I'm sure looking forward to getting some hot and fresh pizza at halftime. If you'd like to place an order, just call 514-845-2222. If you call now, your order will arrive before the end of the first set.
I think I might order some right now. Getting a little hungry up here.
Oh, I know, Chris, I know.
Looks like we are about to get underway here in Love Competition Hall.
As we said, McGill is 3-3 on the season, and they are coming off a game loss against the Université de Montréal-Carabin, and they are looking to pull out the win tonight.
Bonsoir, mesdames et messieurs. Nous vous souhaitons bienvenue à la salle Jean Dalmont pour le match de soir entre les Rougeol
An unfortunate injury to the Hujail squad is that of Marie-Christine Mondor. She is a great player and has been sidelined due to injury. We now stand for the playing of the national anthem. Was McGill's very own fight band playing the national anthem, O Canada.
A very nice rendition, as usual.
Just to repeat, the starting lineup for the Laval Hujail is number 2, Geneviève Bourg-Tremblay, number 3, Sarah Letourneau-Lévesque, number 5, Mélanie Savoie,
Number 8, Stephanie Alexandre. Number 13, Sophie Dallaire. Number 18, Donna Ouellette. And for your McGill Martlets, we have the libero, Daphne André Morin. Number 3, Emily Kite. Number 6, Marcella Mansour. Number 9, Kelsey Irwin. Number 10, Genevieve Plante. Number 13, Alexandra Shepherd. And number 14, Kaiva Mateus. The setter, Marcella Mansour, will now serve to open the game for McGill. And it's long and a big set from Laval. And it's tipped over by Laval with a big set. And McGill takes it to the floor. Emily Kite with a big spike. And it catches the far right corner.
Nice early kill by Emily Kite.
Marcella will now serve. 1 serving 0 McGill. And it's played by Laval and tipped over. And now a big spike from Irwin, and it is just out.
Yes, Irwin is one of McGill's best hitters, but she hits it a little long there.
Got Laval a will now serve. It is Sarah Levesque. And her jumper hits the bottom of the fifth quadrant. And a big spike by McGill. And it could not be handled by the Laval squad. McGill gets a side out there. And it is now Emily Kite who will serve for McGill. 2 serving 1. A deep serve to deep 6. And the set. And a big spike from Melanie Savoie that just goes wide.
Second mistake in a row for Melanie Savoie. She was unable to dig earlier. Hits it a little wide there.
Emily Kite will now serve again. McGill 3 serving 1. And again to deep 6 with a set. And a big smash from Genevieve Bomblay. But it was just wide. And McGill gets another point. 4-1 McGill.
Early on, it's Laval continuing to make some hitting errors. It's going to cost them in the long run if they keep this up.
A nice float serve by Melanie. And the big set and a quick tip by the center, number 18, Donna Ouellette for Laval. But it could not be handled by the McGill squad. And Laval will now go to the line. Number 5, Melanie Savoie serving. 2 serving 4. And her float serve catches the line for an ace. A big serve there for Melanie Savoie to bring the score within 1. Three serving 4, and it's good to upper 6. And a big spike coming from McGill, but is picked up and returned by number 8, Stephanie Alexandre, to tie the score at 4.
Laval really seeming to hit their stride at this point.
Melanie Savoie will go to the line again.
Back to serve, number 5,
we'll see if she can get another ace. That'd be great for the Laval squad this early in the game. Another float serve is picked up in 5 by McGill, and a big set, and it's over. Not controlled. And a big block by Kelsey Irwin there. She stops Laval hard. Kelsey Irwin will now go to the line for McGill. 5 serving 4. And it's good to deep 6. And a big smash from number 2, Genevieve Bourque-Tremblay, and it's dumped over by McGill. And another set for number 8, who's tipped over. That is Stephanie Alexandre. And it's returned by McGill. A backcourt set for Melanie, and she makes it count, taking it to the floor of deep 6.
Great hit there by Melanie Savoie. She's really playing playing great after those early mistakes.
Indeed. Laval's tied it now at 5. And Donna Ouellette is going to attempt a jump serve. And it's good. Hit to deep 5. And a big spike. And she uses the wipe right there. That was Alexandra Shepherd. And she makes it count. Shepherd will now serve. And it's good to deep 6. With a set and a big smash coming from Bourque Tremblay. And it was not handled by the Martlet squad. Geneviève Tremblay will now serve for the Laval Rougeor. It is 6-6 here early in the first. Could not decide who was going to go for that ball.
Caught unawares. Everyone thinks that someone else is going to go for it. That's just...
7 serving 6. And the jumper's good. Oh, and it's not picked up by 13. That is an ace on the serve, on the serve receive error by Alexandra Shepherd. Timeout called by Miguel. Rachel Beliveau is in her 20th season here with the Marlets, and she is done a great job. She has a winning record and is trying to make the most of this season.
Yeah, her team started this season off a little, struggling a little bit, but they did win 3 in a row. Unfortunately, they lost their last game, and they really want to make that up here against Laval.
So far, they're playing well. McGill is trailing 6-8 to Laval, but it's been a fairly tight game. A few errors on both sides, but it is still early in the match, so we'll see how it turns out. A good thing is we have seen a few spikes from Kelsey Irwin already. McGill's key, that's a key for McGill, to for her to play well and hit hard.
Yeah, absolutely. Kelsey Irwin, she really needs to keep on her game. If McGill's going to have a chance.
The libero is actually in right now. Daphne Antemorin, so we'll see how she does. And Geneviève Bourque-Tremblay will now serve for Laval. 8 serving 6. And the jumper lands in middle. With a high set to middle. And it's picked up easily by Laval. And a light attack there by Alexandre, Stephanie Alexandre, but it's good.
Very, very nice, nicely placed right in the back. She had about a foot of space before the line. No one even went for it.
It was quite a well-placed attack. A nice serve pickup there. And a quick spike by number 14, Kaiva Mateus. That, she caught all of that. McGill had a nice side out there. 7 serving 9. With Geneviève Plante going to the line. And a nice jumper to 1. And a big spike. And a great pickup there by McGill. The libero with a nice quick dump over the net. And a big set. And a backcourt attack by Melanie Savoie. But it doesn't go over the net. Geneviève Plante will now serve again for McGill. And the jumper is good. Picked up by the libero and kept in by Sarah Levesque. And a nice attack there. And Laval gets the point.
Plante just shy of picking that one up as she falls to the floor.
Stephanie Alexandre will now serve for Laval, 10 serving 8. And a hard jump serve to deep 1 with a big smash there by McGill, but it's picked up backcourt.
And another big smash by... There we go. Emily Kite takes it to the floor for McGill. McGill will now get a chance to serve.
Very nice line drive there by Emily Kite.
That is her third kill in the game. And it's now 9 serving 10 for McGill. And a good pickup. And a quick dump over there by Tremblay. And a big smash from Kite again. But it's dug and a nice set. And a hard hit that goes wide. Genevieve Tremblay almost had it there. But it was just outside. Kaiva Mateus serves for McGill, and a joust at the net. But McGill comes up with it, and a smash by Kite that's handled easily by the Laval squad. And a return fire from Melanie Savoie that goes wide. McGill now takes the lead. Mateus will now serve again. 11 serving 10 McGill. And she has a nice topspin serve. With a quick back set by Laval, and it is blocked big by Kite. And a big smash by Irwin is dug up by number 2, Tremblay, for Laval. Oh, and I believe that is a net violation there against McGill, so Laval will come up with the point. Sophie Dallaire will now serve for Laval, 11-11. Smash by Kelsey Irwin, and it's picked up by Tremblay, and a backcourt attack by Stephanie Alexandra, and McGill takes it to the floor. Emily Kite, fourth kill of the game. What do you think about that, Chris?
Oh, she's having a great game, and she hit it right on Savoie, who has been making some mistakes.
Very true. Marcella Mansour, the setter for the Martlet squad, will now serve. And a nice deep floater to 6. And a tip over there by Tremblay. And McGill comes in a set. And Emily wipes it off the block. Emily Kite, number 3. Fifth attack. Fifth kill of the game.
That's right.
Emily Kite on fire so far.
Mansour will serve again. McGill 13, Laval 11. And it's deep to 5. And a nice set there by Laval. But McGill comes back. Kelsey Irwin. But it's stuffed by the Laval blockers. And Kite takes it again. But it's again dug up. And a big smash by... Wow, what a smash. Melanie Savoie takes it to the 6-5 seam there. 6-1 seam, sorry.
Savoie's just so good at putting it in the backcourt. She seems to make it seem like the ball's going to go up. But those are well-placed shots.
Indeed, indeed. Laval to the line. And it's into the net. Sarah Levesque could not get it over there.
As we were talking about in our keys of the game, a service error for Laval. It's important for them to keep those down.
McGill will serve again. Emily Kite, 14 serving 12. And it's the deep 6 with a set and a big smash by Savoie. Picked up by McGill and a smash by Irwin there. And a nice wipe there for Tremblay off of the McGill blockers. Melanie Savoie will now serve for Laval, 13 serving 14. And it's to deep 1, and it's just played off the hands of McGill there, and wide. An ace for Savoie.
It looked like Emily Kite, she wanted to go for it, realized at the last second she shouldn't. It was already too late, the ball struck her hand.
That was Savoie's second ace of the game. And another serve that's into the net. Unfortunate, coming off that ace. I guess you can't have it every time there, Chris.
No, you can't win them all.
Martlets will now go to the line. 15 serving 14. Kelsey Irwin. And the 6 foot middle puts it to deep one, and a big smash there. I believe it was number 10, Genevieve Clark. Correction there, that was actually Kaiva Mateus with the smash. Great spike there, and a timeout called by Laval. It's great to see McGill out on top, 16-14 early in the match. It's a tough opponent. What do you think of that, Chris?
Yeah, McGill has been keeping it very simple. They've been playing quite smart. They've actually been doing what Laval's head coach wanted Laval to do, whereas Laval's players have been making some unforced mistakes, and
very
it
true.
Is costing them so far.
Very true, very true. As we were saying, the Laval coach wanted his squad to keep things simple and not make the simple serve-receive and especially service errors. Laval's missed quite a few already. So hopefully, I'm sure that's what he's telling them. Keep it simple, dig, and just dig, set, spike. Dig, set, spike. Play a nice game. Both teams are now taking the court again. McGill 16, Laval 14. Kelsey Irwin at the line. And she has a nice serve to deep five. And it's tipped over, but blocked by McGill. And a big smash by Melanie Savoie. And a set by Mansour and Kelsey Irwin with the smash, but it's dug up by Mansour again. And 16 could not get a handle on that ball, and it falls.
Lots of confusion in the Laval ranks. No one even went for that one. They were all standing around watching.
Very true.